Attacking my job, not me personally. But sometimes you know how it is when you cannot differentiate between my job or my life. That's the whole society I live in. So I'm used to it. I'm working good with it.
Are you going to do more of those sort of movies?
Definitely.
No one's going to stop you.
Well, I think I've done enough. I'm just going to do more of good movies. If it comes in that way, fine. If it comes another way, good.
So it's easy then to say that you are intentionally controversial. You caught controversy on purpose.
No, I'm just a huge sensation. It's not my thing. I don't put things out there to say, okay, this is what I'm doing tomorrow. I just happen to be a media sensation, and it's not my fault at all. But you do
put things out there, because I know that on your Twitter timeline, it's quite interesting. I know very few celebrities in Nigeria that tweet as much as you do.
I just make
Having
them
an
happy.
Opinion,
I make them happy.
You make who happy?
Make my fans happy on Twitter. So it's not like I'm putting anything out there. It's work. I always tell my Twitter people, if I'm on Twitter, it's work for me. I'm not there because I want to play. Twitter is part of my job, trying to mix up with my fans, trying to get to know them, trying to make them love me, and, you know, being in their life and them being in my life. It's work, it's not play.
Is there any role you won't take on?
No, there is no role.
You will do anything?
As long as it's a good story.
That's very good to hear. Very interesting to hear. We'll go back to your Twitter now. You have this language on Twitter that involves a lot of Z's. What is that about? Because even I find it hard sometimes to understand what you're talking about.
I know, right? I just, I don't know why I do that. I think it's just the norm for me to just stand out differently. I really don't know why I do that, but then I replace my S with Z's. It just looks funky and nice, and people talk, so that's a good thing.
But then there was something that happened, and we're going to go back to Twitter now. And your language changed on Twitter. You spoke very good English for a good number of tweets. And that was when you put up the picture on Instagram that had something to do around Indian hemp, I think. Yeah. And you had to retract that and explain what happened. Let's start with the picture now. What happened? Why did that picture come up and why did you put it up?
Oh, well, that was not... I put that picture up, but with a different caption.
Okay.
Because it's just like someone saying, like, I would do something for you on your birthday. I was in London on my birthday, so I was not around. So a lot of people did a lot of things, like create a lot of gift cards, a lot of pictures for me. And I was trying to put them on Instagram to say, okay, this is what people were doing for me. Then I put a different caption on there which says, thank you very much, teammates. Okay? And they now took the picture
with off. With weed, though.
Yeah, I don't know what it was.
Okay.
Well, whatever it is, it was a picture that was given to me. So, they took the picture out from another account that was not mine. So it wasn't necessarily from my account they took it. So I didn't have anything to do with it at all.
But when the NDLEA seems to get involved, there was obviously some sort of agitation from you.
No agitation at all, because nobody contacted me. I just needed to just set it straight. And yes, I spoke correct English that day because it was a serious issue. I was not kidding, and I didn't want anybody to kid me at that time.
What else would make you... That sort of, I mean, like you said, you were not scared, but of course you had to speak good English. Yeah. Is there anything else that would have to happen for you to come out in that sort of way again?
When I'm trying to, like, yeah, I've been doing a campaign on my domestic violence thing and my charity organization. When I'm talking about things as serious as that, since things that implies people's life and helping people, I go straight up, good. You have to be good, because you're cutting across to a lot of people, not just Twitter. It's more like the government officials reading this, more like people who need your help, home and abroad. So it's not just, yes, that's why I differ when I'm speaking something serious.
Let's move on now to something that's a little, also quite controversial. I mean, everything about you is controversial. You went into music.
Yeah.
And I think that was why I first saw the Ziggy. Mm-hmm. There was a single called It's Over
with a
Z.
Yeah.
Right. Is this music thing for you serious, or are you doing it as a pastime just to even gain more attention?
I used to say it was pastime, but now it's serious. It's something that I know that I want to do. I really want to do it.
Do you think you can sing?
I think I can make music work.
I think I can.
I think anybody can sing, but not necessarily having the best voice. But everybody can sing if you're tutored.
The singles you put out, do you think they are good enough?
Well, I wouldn't say they're the best. I criticize myself too. I'm not going to say they're the best, but for someone who's just coming out from this part of the world or this part of entertainment into this, I think I've done a lot and good.
Because one of the songs almost has no lyrics at all.
Yeah, no, the high, right?
Why did you put that out? You saying hi from...
There's something called dubstep. That's what the European people listen to. It's a kind of music. So if we don't know it here, it doesn't mean that it's nothing. It's just that we don't know it here. It's dubstep, and that's what they're listening to in London. So that music will fly in Europe.
Have you taken it to Europe?
Yeah, we did, when I went to London.
And how's it been received there?
Well, it's working.
How's it been received here by your fans? What do you think your fans are saying?
I cannot really tell what they're saying, but I know they're praying for me to keep doing more and keep doing better. I know that.